matter.
This is not your typical murder case. This is a very handsome football player, right, which makes for a nice headline, and sells papers, right?
The tabloids dubbed Fisher's murder the Grid Kid Slay, short for gridiron. The all-American athlete from a well-to-do bucolic New Jersey suburb who somehow found himself too far from home.
They painted Mark Fisher as, you know, the boy next door that was sort of like a lamb that wandered into the den of wolves.
That den, Doreen Giuliano's home. And those wolves, authorities say, some of those kids who show up at her son's after-hours party.
You got a call?
I got a call from John.
And what did he say?
He said, Ma, you need to come home. And I said, is everything okay? And he said, you need to come home.
And so you get home, frantic. What's the scene here?
The press was on my lawn.
Already?
Yeah, and detectives were on my porch.
Why hers? Because remember, her son, John Juca, was the host of that impromptu after-hours party. But Doreen claims there's little to implicate her son. No gun was ever recovered, no fingerprints, no DNA. The only piece of evidence tying Fisher to the Juca home?
Mark Fisher was found laying on top of what turned out to be your blanket.
Yes.
What do you make of that?
You know, Mark Fisher fell asleep on the sofa. And then in the morning, he took the blanket with him.
She claims that is not nearly enough to implicate her son, John, who was going to college for, of all things, criminal law.
What did he want to do?
Well, initially he wanted to be a detective.
Mm-hmm. Ironic.
Yeah, I know.
Besides wanting to get into law enforcement, John had other aspirations as well. He was taking acting classes, and he had actually appeared in School of Rock.
That's Juca, the wannabe actor pushing past actress Joan Cusack.
We used to call him Shady, because he had bleached blonde hair. Just like Eminem at the time.
Did he have that kind of rough street vibe that Eminem has?
No. John came from, you know, money, Catholic high school, didn't grow up in the worst area.
It wasn't a trailer park in 8 Mile.
No. It was a Victorian home on Brooklyn, you know.
Give me a sense of the neighborhood.
Old Victorian, historic.
Not your classic New York City neighborhood.
Oh, no. It's off the beaten path.
A little bit. So where did all of your son's friends live in relationship to here?
In these houses?
Mm-hmm.
And in some of those friends, the cops are now keenly interested in. One of them is that boy who supplied the weed, 17-year-old Antonio Russo, a.k.a. Tweed. Police say almost immediately they want to talk to the local pot pusher. Turns out the morning of Fisher's murder, Russo suddenly decides to chop off those trademark locks.
He had dreadlocks that he had cultivated for years. So for him to get them sheared was very suspect. And then he takes off for California a couple of days later.
Police wonder why the sudden disappearing act.
That certainly makes him the prime suspect.
And there's someone else cops are keeping their eye on.
That's Albert Cleary's house.
This is Albert Cleary's house?
Yeah.
Albert Cleary. He's John Juca's childhood friend who lived just 2 blocks away on Argyle Road. It's just steps away from where police found Mark Fisher's body.
Albert Cleary becomes a prime